Hello children, good morning. This is Vandana. Today I am here to teach you a new chapter, that is chapter 4, The Creation of an Empire. In this chapter, we are going to learn about Mughal dynasty. First, we will learn about who were Mughals. The Mughals were the descendants of two great lineages. From their mother's side, they were the descendant of Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan ruled over Mongol tribes, China, and Central Asia. From their father's side, they were the descendant of Timur. Timur ruled over Iran, Iraq, and modern-day Turkey. Here is the list of some Mughal rulers who ruled over Indian subcontinents. The first came Babur. He ruled from the year of 1526 to 1530. After that, Humayun came. He ruled from the year of 1532 to 1540 and 1555 to 1556. After that, Akbar came. He was a very powerful ruler. He ruled from 1556 to 1605. And then Jahangir came. He ruled from 1605 to 1627. And then Shah Jahan came. He ruled from 1627 to 1658. And then Aurangzeb came. He ruled from 1658 to 1707. After this, there were many other rulers who ruled in India. Let us start with Babur. Babur was the founder of Mughal Empire. He was the descendant of Timur. At first, he was merely interested in conquering those parts of Punjab to which he could lay hereditary claim owing to his Timurian ancestry. The Mughals were descendants of the Mongols, and Mughal is the Persian word for Mongol. Children, you can see Mongolia in this map, and you can see Uzbekistan, which is brown in color, bordering in Kazakhstan. So, children, Babur sent an envoy to Ibrahim Lodi asking Lodi to give up, but Ibrahim Lodi did not pay any heed to such demands. In the following years, Babur invaded northwest India and Punjab several times. So he succeeded to capture those areas. By 1524, he consolidated his position in Afghanistan and he was ready to invade India. It was at such a time that he was invited by Daulat Khan of Punjab. So in the Battle of Panipat in 1526, Babur marched from Kabul for the conquest of India. He crossed Indus and conquered Punjab. Meanwhile, Ibrahim Lodi, overconfident about his larger army, did not do much to resist Babur's progress. He moved leisurely to counter Babur, while Babur sent out spies in every direction to keep a track of Lodi's movement. So this paved the way for the establishment of the mighty Mughal Empire in India. So in the Battle of Khanwa in 1527, Rana Sanga was the mighty ruler of Mewar. He dreamt of restoring the great empire of Prithviraj Chauhan. As soon as he realized that Babur intended to stay in India and he established a new empire, he wanted to establish a new empire, Sangha made efforts to gather a coalition force. In spite of the brave resistance of the Rana, they were defeated in the Battle of Khanwa in 1527. So Rana Sanga escaped to Chittor and the Grand Alliance collapsed. So this is all about the Babur. In the next class, we will study about Humayun.